Hello, my name is Carlos Garcia. I'm a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Glasgow. I'm working in bendable electronics and sensing technologies. And today in this live demo, I'm presenting an energy autonomous electronic skin for robotics. In the University of Glasgow, the electronic skin that we are developing is based on graphene. The single layer graphene that we are using, we are exploring different approaches to transfer graphene in large area over non-conventional substrates. That permits us to develop wearable systems. And the skin that we are developing is sensitive to tactile sense. That means in order to allow robots to interact in a proper way with the environmental objects, we need to fabricate gloves, smart gloves, that they have an array of sensors allowing the robot to apply the proper grabbing for non-conventional objects like fragile objects, rigid objects, soft objects. So in this case, in this demo, we are presenting a patterning technique based on blade cutter that allows the graphene to have a capacitive structure. And this structure, once it's embedded in a polymer, in this case we are using PDMS, the resulting device is robust and is stable over time. We have tested these devices under different bending conditions, which make them to be suitable for wearable electronics. In this case, we are presenting a single layer graphene on top of a solar cell because we have explored in the state of the art wearable electronics, and we have seen that there is a lack of energy sources supplying energy for different capacitive structures. In this case, our sensors are driven with a solar cell, taking advantage of graphene transparency. Graphene absorbs 1.5% of light, and that allows graphene to not absorb too much white light, and the energy is harvested by the solar cell and drives a simple electronics that you can see on the other side of our sensors. So we have the sensors, on top of that we have a solar cell, and the whole vertical stack structure forms a really compact structure at low cost. On top of that, we have a wide range of sensitivities in this kind of sensor. So when I'm touching the structure, I'm producing, as you can see here, a high sensitivity response from the sensors. As you can see in this video, these sensors will be able to communicate, to give a feedback to the robotic hands in order to interact in a proper way with objects. In the University of Glasgow, we are also developing different low-cost prototypes of prostheses. In this case, compared to the commercial one, they will allow more people to get in the market. In this case, these custom versions of the 3D printed robotic hands allow us to design in a proper way those areas that will be covered with the electronic skin. And that's all from my side. Thank you for your attention.